Dear students, welcome to eShikshana program. I am Dr. V. Ramchandra Murthy, Professor of Mathematics, RR Institute of Technology, Chikkabanavara, Bengaluru. First of all, I would like to thank the authorities of VTU Belagam for identifying me as subject expert to deliver lectures of Mathematics 4, Complex Analysis, Probability and Statistical Methods with bearing code 18MAT41 in eShikshana Program 3. I thank the management and principal RR Institute of Technology for their academic support and encouragement for me to involve in this program. As you all know, fourth semester mathematics course is revised. This course is a 3-credit course with 5 modules. I'll be taking classes on module 3, that is probability and distribution. So this is the details of the module 3, probability distributions. First of all, let me give a brief introduction to probability. What is probability? Probability is a chance or a study of uncertainty. We generally comment on uncertainties of happenings of some events in our day-to-day life. For example, we make sentences like, possibly it will rain. There is a high chance of getting the job next month. This year's demand for the product is likely to exceed that of the last year's. In industries, managers often base their decisions on an analysis of uncertainties as the following. What are the chances that sales will decrease if we increase prices? What is the likelihood a new assembly method will increase productivity? How likely is it that the project will be finished on time? What is the chance that a new investment will be profitable? All these words, likelihood, possibly, likely, high chance, in the above sentences indicate the degree of uncertainty about the happening of an event. The numerical measure of uncertainty is provided by very important branch of mathematics called the theory of probability. Broadly, there are 3 possible states of expectations: certainty, impossibility, and uncertainty. The probability theory describes certainty by 1, impossibility by 0, and various grades of uncertainties by numerical value ranging between 0 and 1. So probability as a numerical measure of likelihood of an event occurring. So this is the increase in likelihood of occurrence as it passes through this arrow mark, that is increase. So this is most likely, this is not likely, or 50%, something like that. So it increasing in the likelihood of occurrence. The probability is 0, that is impossible event. When the probability numerical measure is 1, a certain event, when it is the measure 0.5, the occurrence of the event is just as likely as it is unlikely. So the numerical measure of probability, as it approaches 1, the chances of happening of that particular event is more. If the value approaches towards 0, the chances of happening of that particular event is less. Basic terminologies. Random experiment. If in each experiment conducted under identical conditions, the outcome is not unique, but maybe one of the several possible outcomes, then Such an experiment is called a random experiment. For example, result of a cricket match before it is played. Throwing a coin, three coins, is also a random experiment. Then throwing die is also random experiment. Example of a random experiment. Trial and event. Any particular performance of a random experiment is called a trial, and outcome or combinations of outcomes are termed as events or cases. For example, if a coin is tossed repeatedly, the result is not unique. We may get any of the two faces, tail or head. Tossing a coin is a trial, and getting head or tail is an event. Mutually exclusive events. Events are said to be mutually exclusive if the happening of any one of them rules out the happening of all others. That is, if no two or more than two of them can happen simultaneously. For example, in tossing a coin, the events head and tail are mutually exclusive, since if the outcome is head, the possibility of getting tail in the same trial is ruled out. In throwing a die, all six faces are mutually exclusive. Equally likely events. Events are said to be equally likely if there is no reason to expect anyone in preference to any other. For example, in throwing a die, all the six faces are equally likely. When a card is drawn from a well-shuffled pack, any card may appear in the draw, so that 52 different cards are equally likely. Exhaustive events. It is the total number of all possible outcomes. Total number of all possible outcomes in any trial is known as exhaustive events or exhaustive cases. For example, in throwing a die, there are six exhaustive cases for any one of the six faces may turn up. In throwing a coin, there are two exhaustive cases, namely head and tail. In throwing three coins, there are eight exhaustive cases. Favorable events. It is the total number of cases in which that particular event happens. The cases which entail the happening of an event are said to be favorable to the event. It is the total number of possible outcomes in which the specified event happens. Example, in a throw of two dice, the number of cases favorable to getting a sum 6 is 5, namely 2, 4, 4, 2, 1, 5, 5, 1, and 3, 3. Independent and dependent events. Two or more events are said to be independent if the happening or non-happening of any one does not depend by the happening or non-happening of any other. Otherwise, they are said to be dependent. For example, if a card is drawn from a pack of well-shuffled cards and replaced before drawing the second draw, the result of the second draw is independent of the first draw. However, if the first card drawn is not replaced, then the second draw is dependent on the first draw. Now let us come to the definition of probability, mathematical or classical definition of probability. If a trial results in n exhaustive, mutually exclusive, and equally likely events, and m of them are favorable to the happening of an event E, then the probability of happening of E is given by small p is equal to probability of happening of E is equal to favorable number of cases divided by exhaustive number of cases, that is equal to m by n, where m stands for favorable number of cases and n is the exhaustive number of cases. When m or the are in favor of happening of e, its complement n minus m are the cases in which the e will not happen. So there are n minus m cases which are unfavorable to the happening of e. So therefore, the probability that the event will not happen is given by p of e bar is equal to unfavorable number of cases divided by exhaustive number of cases, that is equal to unfavorable number of cases n minus m, exhaustive number of cases n. So if you divide n minus m by n, you get, so we denote probability of e bar by q and probability of e by small p. So q is equal to n minus m by n. So if you divide n minus m by n, we get n by n, that is 1 minus m by n, but m by n is p. M by n is p. So therefore, q is equal to 1 minus p, or p plus q is equal to 1. So clearly, both p and q lies between 0 and 1, inclusive 0 and 1. If p of e is equal to 1, e is said to be a certain event, that is a numerical measure of probability is 1, then that is that particular event is certain, so e is said to be a certain event. If probability of e is 0, that is probability of e bar is equal to 1, then e is an impossible event as it takes the numerical measure 0. Statistical or empirical definition of probability. If in n trials an event e happens m times, then the probability of happening of e is given by probability of e is equal to limit as n tends to infinity m by n. Product rule. So these two rules usually we use in our problems. So note one, product rule. Suppose an event E can occur in m ways and an event F can occur in n ways. The combination of E and F can occur in m into n ways. Note two, sum rule. If an event can occur in m ways and another event can occur in n ways, there are m plus n ways in which either of two events can occur. Permutation. An arrangement formed by selecting r things out of n things and placing them in a definite order is called permutation of n things taken r at a time. It is denoted by p of n comma r is equal to np r is equal to factorial n divided by factorial n minus r. Combination. The selection of r things out of n without reference to the other, without reference to the order, is called a combination of n things taken r at a time. It is denoted by c of n comma r is equal to ncr is equal to factorial n divided by factorial n minus r into factorial r. So let us take some problems. A point problem one. A point is chosen at random inside a rectangle measuring 3 by 5 inches. Find the probability p that the point is at least 1 inch from the edge. The question is, a point is chosen at random inside a rectangle measuring 3 by 5 inches. Find the probability p that the point is at least 1 inch from the edge. So let us consider the set S consisting of all points inside a rectangle measuring 3 by 5. So like this, set of all points inside a rectangle measuring 3 by 5. And further, let us consider set A of all points at least 1 inch from the edge, of this rectangle 3 by 5. So 1 inch from either side and from either side 1 inch less, so it makes 2, 5 minus 2, 3 inches. And in this direction, 1 inch less from this edge, 1 inch less from this edge, the 3 minus 2, so that makes 1 inch. So this is 1 inch and 3 inches, this rectangle A. So A consists of all points which are at least 1 inch from the edge, at least 1 inch from the edges, all edges. So I really cannot count how many. This is the area which favors to the happening of that particular event. That is, the point is at least 1 inch from the edge. So I cannot really count the points. So I consider the entire area as a favorable to the happening of that particular event. The exhaustive is this entire set S inside the set of all points inside the rectangle measuring 3 by 5. So the required probability is this area of A divided by exhaustive, this area of S. So area of A, length into breadth, 1 into 3, and similarly area of S, 3 into 5. So 3, you can cancel, so 1 by 5. So required probability is 1 by 5. Second problem. What is the chance that a leap year selected at random will contain 53 Sundays? So we all know that a leap year consists of 52 complete weeks and 2 days over. That is 364 days, that makes 52 complete weeks and 2 days plus 2 days. So these 2 days, we don't know what it is. If we know 364th day, then we can tell what is its 365th and 366th days. So these 2 days can be one of the form. If the 364th day is Sunday, then 365th day will be Monday, then the next day is Tuesday, so like that we can form. But since we don't know, so these 2 days can be Sunday, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So like this, Sunday, Monday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Okay, that is the exact number of cases is, there are 7 cases, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The exact number of cases is 7. So in this 7, there are 2 cases which are in favor of Sunday. That is first one and the 7th one. So favorable number of cases is 2. So the required probability is 2 by 7. That is equal to 0.2857. Problem number 3. Two unbiased dice are thrown. Find the probability that both the dice show the same numbers, 2. The first die shows 6. 3. The total of the numbers on the dice is 8. The total of the numbers on the dice is greater than 8. Fifth one, the total of the numbers on the dice is 13. Sixth one, the total of the numbers on the dice is any number from 2 to 12 both inclusive. Okay. In throwing a pair of dice or two dice, unbiased dice, there are 36 cases. So the exhaustive number of cases is equal to 36. So that can be arranged in a matrix form like this. So let us, for our convenience, let us consider the first component is coming from the first die, second component coming from the second die. Okay, now let us go to the question. So this means the exact number of cases is 36. Both the dice show the same number. What is the probability that both the dice show same numbers? That means first die, second die showing the same numbers. So that you can see in this diagonal line, 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 3 comma 3, 4 comma 4, 5 comma 5, 6 comma 6. So all these cases show both the dice having the same number. So there are 6 cases, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in favor of that particular event. So therefore, the required probability is 6 divided by exact number of cases is 36, favorable number of cases is 6. So 6 by 36 is equal to 1 by 6. Now, question number 2. The first die shows 6. So as I told you, for our convenience, let us consider the first component coming from first die, second component coming from second die. The first component having 6. So in this column, all the first die are showing a number 6. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 cases favoring that this particular event to happen. So favorable number of cases is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And exact number of cases is 36. So the required probability is 6 divided by 36 is 1 by 6. The total of the numbers on the dice is 8. So when you take the sum of both the faces, numbers on the both the faces, it should be 8. And you can easily make out from this matrix here. 2, 6, 8, 3, 5, 8, 4 plus 4, 8, 5 plus 3, 8, 6 plus 2, 8. So none of the other cases give the sum 8 except these cases, that is 2, 6, 6, 2, 5, 3, 3, 5, and 4, comma 4. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 cases favor in this particular event to happen. So the number of favorable number of cases is 5. Exact number of cases is 36. So therefore, the required probability is 5 divided by 36. Question number 4. The total of the numbers on the dice is greater than 8. Look at this matrix once again. Greater than 8. So this is the line which we have seen in the last case giving the sum 8. So the cases which are diagonally opposite to this, that is 3, 6, 4, 5, 5, 4, 6, 3, they all make 9, and 4, 6, 5, 5, 6, 4, they all make 10, 5, 6, 6, 5, they make 11, and 6 and 6, 6 plus 6 is 12. So all these cases are the sum of the numbers greater than 8. So all these cases are in favor of this particular event to happen. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 cases are in favor of this particular event to happen. And therefore, favorable number of cases is 10. Exact number of cases is 36. So therefore, the required probability is 10 by 36, that is 5 divided by 80. Fifth question. The total of the numbers on the dice is 13. So in this, all possible outcomes, there are 36 outcomes, none of the cases give the addition of the numbers is exceeding 12. 12 is the maximum, 2 is the minimum. So getting the sum 13 is out of question. So this is an impossible event. Therefore, the probability is 0. This is an impossible event, so required probability is 0. Sixth one, the total of the numbers on the dice is any number from 2 to 12, both inclusive. So in this matrix, you can see the least is 2 and the highest is 12. All other numbers fall between 2 and 12. That makes 3 here, 4 here, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So all the cases support this particular event to happen. So there are 36 favorable number of cases. So the required probability is 36 by 36 is 1. So that means this is a certain event. Question number 4. An urn contains 5 red and 10 black balls. 8 of them are replaced in another urn. What is the probability that the latter contains 2 red and 6 black balls? The question is, an urn contains 5 red and 10 black balls. 8 of them are replaced in another urn. What is the probability that the latter contains 2 red and 6 black balls? So out of 15 balls in an urn, 8 of them are replaced in another urn. It can come in any form: 5 red, 3 black, 4 red, 4 black, 3 red, 5 black, 2 red, 6 black, 1 red, 7 black. So there are many combinations. So what is this? Is 2 red and 6 black is one of the combination. So what is the probability that the letter contain 2 red and 6 black balls is the problem. So total number of balls, 5 red and 10 black balls, that is 15 balls. 8 of them are removed and replaced in another urn. That means you are selecting 8 out of 15 balls. So that can be done in 15C8 ways. So the exact number of cases is 15C8. So now let us look at the favorable cases. So the latter contains two, probability of latter contains 2 red and 6 black balls. So 2 red balls should come from 5 red balls only. So 2 can come from 5 red balls in 5C2 ways. Similarly, 6 black should come from these 10 black balls only. It can come in 10C6 ways. So therefore, favorable number of cases of 2 red and 6 black balls is 5C2 into 10C6. So favorable number of cases, 5C2 into 10C6. Therefore, the required probability is favorable number of cases divided by exact number of cases is equal to 0.33. Question number 5. If 4 squares are chosen at random on a chessboard, find the probability that they should be in a diagonal line. So 4 squares are chosen at random on a chessboard. So we know chessboard has 64 squares. 4 squares are chosen at random on a chessboard. That means 4 squares are selected out of 64 in 64C4 ways. That is, the exhaustive number of cases is 64C4. Okay, let us take a look at this chessboard. The markings are not very clear, but still we can make out. So 64, so 8 squares on horizontal side, 8 squares on the vertical side. So they make into 64 squares. The question is, find the probability that they should be in a diagonal line. So there are, this is the principal diagonal AB, and many diagonals are there which are parallel to AB on either side. So there are totally, there are 64 squares, and 4 squares chosen at random can come in 64 C4 ways. That is, our exhaustive number of cases is equal to 64, and these 4 squares are in a diagonal line. So there are many diagonals. So this is also a diagonal, this is another diagonal, this is another diagonal, but on these diagonals 4 squares cannot fit in. But from here, A4 and B4, look at this diagonal, A4 and B4, the lower, least one from this side, there are 4 squares can be accommodated, 1, 2, 3, 4 in a line, on this diagonal line. So this can be done only in one way, that is 4C4, 4 out of 4, 4C4, that is only one way. Along another diagonal line, A3, B3, there are 5 squares, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 4 out of 5 can be selected in 5C4 ways. Similarly, this diagonal A2, B2, a line parallel to this diagonal line AB, A2, B2 has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 squares. So 4 can be chosen out of these 6 in 6C4 ways. Similarly, A1, B1 has 7 squares and 4 can come in 7C4 ways. And along AB, 8 squares. So 4 squares can come out of 8 in 8C4 ways. Similarly, this is a replica of this A1 dash B1 dash is a replica of A1 B1. So here also of 7 squares, so it can come in 7C4 ways. Similarly, along A4 dash A2 dash B2 dash 6C4, along A3 dash B3 dash 5C4, along A4 dash B4 dash 4C4. Therefore, thus, the total number of cases in which 4 squares selected at random are in diagonal line AB and lines parallel to AB is twice from year to year. That is twice, 4C4 plus 5C4 plus 6C4 plus 7C4 plus 8C4. 8C4 is coming from the diagonal AB. Yeah. Similarly, you can consider another diagonal line CD and lines parallel to CD and can come out with a similar number of cases in which 4 squares selected at random are in a diagonal line CD and lines parallel to CD. That is twice 4C4 plus 5C4 plus 6C4 plus 7C4 plus 8C4. Therefore, favorable number of cases is equal to twice 4C4 plus 5C4 plus 6C4 plus 7C4 plus 8C4. So this is the favorable number of cases. Our exact number of cases is 64C4. Therefore, the required probability is two times 4C4 plus 5C4 plus 6C4 plus 7C4 plus 8C4 divided by 64C4. So that makes 364 by 63,635,376, that is 0.00057. Next question. Suppose there are 10 plants labeled A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and J. If two plants are selected at random, what is the probability that A is selected, A is not selected, A and B are selected, A or B is selected, neither A nor B is selected? So there are 10 plants named A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and J. And two plants are selected at random. So these two plants, suppose if A, B are selected, then B, A is same as A, B. So we note that the order of selection is not relevant. For example, choice AB is same as choice B. So there are 10 plants, two plants are selected at random. So that can be done in 10C2 ways. So 10C2 makes 45. So exhaustive number of cases is 45. Now, what is the probability that A is selected? A is selected with all other combinations. See, A can come with B, then with C, with D. So it makes pairs with B1, with C2, D3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And they are AB, AC, AD, AE, AF, AG, AH, AI, and AJ. So there are 9 cases, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 cases. The favorable number of cases is equal to 9, and exhaust number of cases is 45. So therefore, the required probability, that is probability of E1. So what is E1? E1 is the event that A is selected. So probability of A is selected, or probability of E1, is 9 divided by 45 is 0.2. So consider the second, A is not selected. That means all cases should come from B to J only, all combination, B with C, C with D, B with E, all combination. So two cases, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 plants named B to J. So 2 can be selected in 9C2 ways. So 9C2 makes 9 into 8 by 1 into 2, so 36. So favorable number of cases is 36. So what is E2? E2 is the event A is not selected. Exhaust number of cases is 45. Therefore, probability of A is not selected is P of E2 is equal to 36 divided by 45. That makes 0.8. Third problem. A and B are selected. So both A and B are selected. That means it can be a combination of A and B only. So none of the combination can come into this particular event. So there is exactly one event which supports the combination of A and B. So a favorable number of cases for this problem, A and B are selected, is 1. So therefore, therefore probability of A and B are selected, that is probability of E3, is equal to 1 divided by 45 is 0.22. Look at the question number D. A or B is selected. So A can be there or B also can be there. So what is the favorable number of cases in this particular case? A or B is selected. So again, A can go with all this. A with B, C, A with D, A with E, A with F, A with G, A with H, A with I, and A with J. So it can make 9 pairs. A, B, 1, C, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Involving A, R, B. So B cannot go with A because already A, B is there. So now B can make all combination. B with C, D with E, with F, with G, with H, with I, with J. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So favorable number of cases in this case is 9 plus 8, that makes 17. That makes 17. Therefore, probability of A or B is selected is 17 divided by 45 is equal to 0.37. The probability of neither A nor B is selected. So A and B are not selected. So A, B cannot be in any of the combination. That means, so these two we should leave out. So all combinations starting from C to J, that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8. So 2 can be selected in 8C2 ways. 8C2 is 8 into 7 by 1 into 2. So that makes 28. So favorable number of cases is 28. So therefore, probability of neither A nor B selected is 28 by 45 is equal to 0.62. So in this particular lecture, just to summarize, I started from the introduction part of probability and then various terminologies involved leading to definition of probability, both mathematical and statistical definition or empirical definition. Then some problems which are of interest in this particular probability theory. So your syllabus start from random variables. This is only the introduction to the probability theory. So I'll be starting random variables and other topics in my next lecture. Thank you.